Hey everybody, I am live. I hope you guys are doing well. If it's some friends around, I want some people to go and come into the room if you can. Let me see if I could tag some folk. See if anybody is around, because I just have a question for you guys. If anybody comes in, I'm gonna see. I can get some people to come into the live. Oh my God. If y'all here, how y'all doing today? How are you guys? I just wanted to pose a question with a show of thumbs up. How many people heard of CPN numbers? Because I'm getting a lot of questions in reference to CPN numbers. CPN numbers. If you heard of it, okay, I got a heart. Anybody else? And have you guys have heard of CPN numbers? Good afternoon. Anybody? Okay, we got some thumbs up. I just want to give you guys some information because I get this question often about CPN numbers, but I want to give you guys a train of thought. Now, I know a lot of people, and if you can, this video, I usually don't ask, share this with your friends and family, because there's a lot of people that want to get CPN numbers, okay? And they ask a lot about CPN. Now, if you don't know, a CPN number is a number, and a lot of people will, you know, pose this. It's not illegal. It's a profile number that if you're like a celebrity or someone who don't want to reveal if you get in a car or extending trying to, you know, apply for credit, that the person doesn't have or people don't have your personal information. So say if you're a Beyonce, you know, Jay-Z, you might not want people to know who you are when you are applying for credit. If you're a senator, celebrity, so you can get a CPN number. And it is a credit profile number instead of using your social number, okay, social security number. So I guess there's a lot of people that want to hit the restart button and they will purchase or establish CPN numbers because I guess they want to, you know, some kind of way reestablish their credit history. But I just want to let you guys know, you know, when it comes down to CPNs, it may be legal in theory, but if you're taking that number and filling out an application and getting federal funding, getting a mortgage under that CPN number, that is illegal. You are not supposed to use that. Instead, if they're asking you on that application, you are not supposed to substitute your social security number with that CPN number. I just want y'all to know that. I don't want to see anybody going to jail for fraud because everybody tried to reinvent the wheel. My question is with the CPN number, and I'm posing a question because maybe somebody can educate me on this. Why wouldn't you just get an EIN number? Why not that? That's starting a business. You can get an EIN number for what, 50 bucks through the IRS, and even in your own personal name, you could do business as a sole proprietorship and just get an EIN number or start some kind of business and reestablish your credit by doing business credit. You don't have to put a personal guarantee for business credit if you develop it. You know, you got to go through getting that 30s, and it's a whole nother process. If you don't want to do that, where items are not, you don't have to personally guarantee it in your name, but that is totally possible to do. And what, 9 months, try to establish a business credit. When it comes to these CPN numbers, you can't run out and get credit like that anyway. There's nothing that you have to some kind of way establish that number to report on that, some kind of profile, like with the bureaus. And
you know, a lot of them, they'll advise you to get secured credit cards and establish over a period of time, maybe a couple of months. And they say then you might can get a checking account. But if you can just get an EIN number and establish a business, you can get a checking account fairly quickly. Even if you have some problems, if you establish an LLC, you can bring other people in on your LLC, your limited liability company. And not only can you get a bank account, you can have your relatives. Is that what you want to bring in on your corporation to establish the bank account as a board member? So what I'm just trying to tell people, everybody is trying to find, it's nothing wrong with trying to find a shortcut or a way to do things, but you have to be careful on how you're doing things. There's always another way, and you can use business credit, and business credit does not attach to your own or report to your own personal credit. And usually you get about 3 times as much credit on a business credit card than you do with a normal personal credit card, and you will have access to those funds, and it will not report to your credit report. So if you have an $8,000 credit limit with, let's say, Chase, even if you personally guaranteed it, it will not report to your credit report. So that whole factor of, sorry about that, somebody was there. But that whole factor of your debt to available credit ratio wouldn't even come into play. Like when you max out your own personal credit cards, then your personal credit would take a hit. It doesn't work like that with business credit. So all you would be doing is personally guaranteeing it. Now, what you need to do, there are certain things in order for you to personal guarantee. Usually, you need to be in a ballpark of a 680 credit score, a credit limit of a primary account in your name of a credit card of $5,000, which isn't hard to do. If you read my book about merchandise cards, a quick guide on how to boost your credit using merchandise cards, that's part of the strategy of doing that, to get yourself an increased credit limit. And you shouldn't have no more than 3 inquiries on your credit report or pulls in a year. So to me, just with this information, you guys, that CPN number, be very careful with that. You know, sometimes the best way is, you got to look at things in life called risk worth reward. You know, like, what is the risk worth the reward? So even if you are able to borrow $100,000, is it worth you to possibly go to jail? Or let's say it's just illegal. It is legal. Is it worth you for even being accused of doing something illegal and you have to hire attorneys? Is it worth it? So sometimes don't always go with the fads of things. And I know it's something that's been established for decades, but be careful on what people are offering you. And sometimes you need to think about what you're doing, because there's a lot of people that inbox me about CPN numbers, and you just better be very careful. All I'm asking you to do before you get involved, do some research and tell me why you can't just get an EIN number, which is totally legal. And better yet, baby, you'll get some tax write-offs because you started a business. Just saying, I'm selling cookies. Okay, and just do it in your name, locally, secure, that doing business name with your local municipality, and boom, you're in business. It's called a sole proprietorship. Okay, you can do that, and then get an EIN number and start building credit. Well, like, what's the deal? And then with that, connect a secured bank account, a secured credit card, what they're telling you to do anyway. Why can't you do that? and bill that. It all makes no sense to me. So all it sounds like to me, that people might get themselves in some serious legal trouble, which I try to avoid all of that. In this system, which I call the Matrix, why would you need sentinels popping up at your door, Agent Smith coming your way because you are making a ruckus in the Matrix? Why even have that? And Agent Smith won't be the agent you're thinking about. It'll be the FBI's, okay? Why would you even want to get involved in that? And what's the reward worth the risk? It just make no... me personally, nothing is on the table for my freedom. And that's if I can help it. So God bless anybody else. Hey, you know, the laws isn't for the lawful. It's for the lawless. So if you don't mind doing some jail time, hey, you better than me. But my brother always used to tell me the most dangerous person you have to watch in this world is the person that ain't afraid to go to jail. So if you ain't afraid to go to jail, keep your distance from me, because you just liable to do anything. And sometimes, you know, as they say, fast money ain't always good money. So you just got to be careful. So just put this warning for your friends and family before y'all just start going, trying to establish, getting the EIN number. Ask yourself the question. CPN number. Ask yourself the question why you just can't get an EIN number and establish things as a business. And then get some tax write-offs and be legit. I just don't get that. Like, where's the risk worth the reward? So be careful. Especially a lot of this stuff just sound janky, if you ask me. Just janky. Why would you want to be in something janky? I don't. I mean, if you want to all help it, why would you even want to get yourself into problems? So I just want to give y'all that tip for those that's asking about that. Not to criticize you. I'm just telling you. I always want you, even if you read my stuff or hear my stuff that I propose to you, always do critical thinking. Just don't eat out of nobody's mouth. You know, you look into these things and find out about how the system works. You just got to be very careful with that CPN number, you guys. I will tell you that. And I know I have some people that will go back and forth. Well, celebrities are doing it. But baby, you ain't a celebrity. And you ain't got celebrity money to fight lawsuits, baby. Don't do that. Even with the IRS. Oh, you ain't got to pay taxes? Maybe so. It's not constitutional. Mm-hmm. Wesley Snipes was on that too. And he did that jail time. See, I ain't got time to be in jail for nobody. So I'm just going to just do what I need to do towards my taxes. But what you can do is learn the tax code and then you establish yourself as such that you minimize your taxes. But all this other tomfoolery, not for me. So I'm just putting that out there for y'all. I just posed that question. If y'all want to go with a CPN number, you do a little research in an EIN number that will be totally legal, point blank. And you could probably develop it the same way you're doing that CPN number in that same time. So I hope this information is valuable, because like I said, share that with your friends and your family. They just got to be, you know, careful. You can fix your own credit. Kind of like easily if you really learn the credit system. That's why I write the books. That's why I give you information. Even bankruptcies you can get off in a certain timing. You could just about get a lot of things off your credit if you really knew how, and it ain't that complicated, and it's totally legal instead of doing stuff that's illegal or borderline illegal. So don't even get yourself, in my opinion, caught up on it. But at the end of the day, who am I? You know, you do what you feel that's best for you. But anything on that level of being janky, I ain't in it. My name is Bennett, and I surely ain't in it. And I don't even want people thinking to put the heat on my back, because they locked Martha Stewart up. I sure ain't trying to go and do no Fed time. And I know she got more money than I did. So if you think you better than Martha Stewart, and you want to mess around with the F, a B, and the I, be my guest, because I ain't doing it. So I hope this is information is beneficial to you guys, and just watch out what people are offering and research things. So I hope you guys are enjoying your day. God bless. Afternoon to you, Carolyn. Afternoon, and everyone else that's tuning in. I really appreciate you guys. And I hope, like I said, share this information with your friends and family before they get into that CPN. Let them know maybe you should go a different route. Because if you have children or whatever, you don't want to see people get tied up because they're trying to do things way too... And it's not about doing it fast. It's just doing it in the wrong direction. You could just do it another way in the same time anyway. And it's totally legal. So I really don't even get what people are talking about. You know, I don't get it. Now, somebody can educate me. I'm not the smartest person in the room, but why you need to do that anyway? I don't get it. Even if you want to be on a corporation, and you can hire agents that actually will receive your mail, register for you in a different state, and your name ain't gotta really even be on it like that. So I'm trying to figure out why people are even coming up with that. I don't get that. Like, why are you doing that? I don't get it. And you could get a legal tax break. So if somebody done can dispute that train of thought for me and say, oh, well, you got it wrong. No, you can't just jump out and use a CPN number without trying to build a profile anyway. Well, why don't you just use a EIN number and do it legally? And it don't take much. And you could do it as a sole proprietorship totally in your name. What sense does that make? That it makes absolutely none to me. So I'm just telling y'all, just consider what I'm saying before you get yourself all caught up. All right? You guys are more than welcome. I hope this is beneficial. Like I said, please express that to your friends and family, because I know it's somebody out here getting caught up in that. Okay, or looking for that, because there's too many people that contact me about it. Okay, so just be careful, you guys. I hope this is informational. If not, just, you know, check in to all things yourself. Even if you saying, hey, later for her or that, just make sure you research it out. All right, God bless. Bye-bye.